everybody. Just thought I would share with you my Saturday project. I wasn't going to share it, but then after I got everything set up, I thought, well, I'll just turn the camera on and give y'all some snippets of what I'm doing in case some of you may have something similar you want to do. And I'm just really just showing you the before and after and show you how really easy it is. Wanted to buy some new tables for my den. That's our casual area where we watch TV and things. And I just didn't want to go spend $400 or $500 on one coffee table. So I had these tables. This is a side table between our recliners, and this is a sofa table I have over on the side of the wall. I still love the look of it, and what I was looking for is something very similar, maybe not so Queen Anne-ish looking legs, but maybe something a little more, you know, casual. With the painted furniture being so popular and stuff, I thought, you know, I'm just going to give it a try. I'm going to chalk paint it and distress it and see how I like it. If I make a total mess of it, then nothing lost. I've had these tables 25 years, and I'll just go buy what I want. Every store you go in now, this is what you're seeing. So I thought I'd just give it a try. In addition, I probably need some new sheets, don't I? These sheets are probably 25 years old, these Barney sheets. My daughter's almost 30, but they're just some work drop calls. I brought my tables out here. I just wiped them down with a wet cloth. You know, with chalk paint, you should not have to do any prep whatsoever. However, I am just going to take a little bit of sandpaper and knock the sheen off. I'm not sanding them down to bare wood or anything like that. I'm just literally just knocking the sheen off. And I'm also going to try my hand at making my own chalk paint. I'll show you what I use to make it. It appears to be pretty simple, so we'll see from there. But I'm going to paint these kind of a red look, a red distressed look, so we'll see. This is how I'm making up my own chalk paint. I just got me a little plastic tub, and I went to Walmart, and I found a color I like. Well, I ended up having 2 cups of paint, which is 8 of these containers, which cost me $4. So I got 4 Tuscan Red and 4 Barn Red, and I put it in this bowl. I put 2 tablespoons of water, and then I put 1/4 cup of Plaster Paris. Now, this Plaster Paris I've had forever. This is the kind that you can buy like at Hobby Lobby and craft stores, but they do sell it at Walmart for like 1/2 gallon box for like $4. Plaster Paris is super cheap, and I just mixed it all together. I'll have the chalk paint recipe below in case you didn't catch what I said, but it's just those 3 ingredients. And then I bought this little $2 brush at Walmart, and I'm going to stir it up even more and start painting my tables. Y'all, I was going to show y'all my first coat on the sofa table. And you can see that I had 2 cups of paint after I added the 2 other ingredients. And how I knew how much to paint to even start with is I saw on the internet where a 6-drawer dresser would take about 2 cups of paint. I kind of went from that, and I figured these 2 tables would certainly could be covered with 2 cups of paint. And I believe I guesstimated it right. But so far, the homemade chalk paint is working beautifully. I'm wanting that dull, rustic red look. And this is exactly what I'm going for. So it's still kind of wet. It's going to dry matte. But so far, so good. Even if I bought the Plaster of Paris, that'd be 4 plus 4. I've got less than $10 tied up in chalk paint, and that's a whole lot cheaper than buying it already made. When I get back with you, I'll have sandpaper ready to distress it some. I want to show you the tables now. They're dried, and I went and took some 100 grit sandpaper and just went over it, especially accentuating some of the edges on the table, like here and then down here on the legs where it, you know, where you see some character in the wood. They're not as dark as what I want them. What I'm going to use is some of this. You get this at Walmart. It is the antique wax. It looks like chocolate syrup. It really does. But I'm going to rub some of this on there and then let that dry. I'm going to rub that on with a little t-shirt just to accent some of these places that I have distressed. And I think that'll give me the darkness that I'm looking for. All right, I want to show you my tables now that I've got my brown wax rubbed on there. It kind of brightened them back up for sure. It covered up some of the distressing that I did. I'm happy with the result because they definitely match my TV stand better than what they were originally. So I'm going to leave them as is. I'm going to put a clear satin coat. I'll show you in the morning what I'm going to use. Friends, it is the next day. It is still 91 degrees in my garage, so these coats of paints are going to dry pretty quick. Let me show you what I'm going to do my last clear coat on. This is Minwax Polyacrylic Protective Finish, and I bought the clear satin. This is $16 at Walmart. I don't know if you get it cheaper at Lowe's or somewhere. I was a little surprised it was that expensive. From what I've read, this is the best to use as far as your finish protective coat. I had this little table that I had some leftover chalk paint. I went ahead and just painted it the burgundy color too. Real pleased with it. When I get back with you, I'll show you my tables in the house, all complete.